Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So, in the last class, we studied how to do multiplication by three-digit multipliers, and also we saw how to do estimation of product. Right? So, in today's class, we'll learn how to do division by one-digit divisors. So, first, we'll do a quick revision on what we did in the last class. So, we saw multiplication by three-digit multipliers. So, how do you do that? So, let's see to an example. First, we have 324 multiplied by 514. So first what we do, now here 324 is the multiplicand and 514 is the multiplier. Okay, so first we multiply 324 with 4 in 514. Okay, that is the ones place. So 324 into 4, when you do, we have 4 fours are 16, so we write 6 and carry over 1. Then 4 twos are 8, 8 plus 1 9, and 4 threes are 12. So we get 1296. Then we have 324 into 10, we get 3240. Then when we do 3324 into, now we have, we in hundreds place we have 5, so we multiply with 500. So first we'll write two zeros in ones and tens place and then multiply 5 with 324, so we get 1,62,000. Then what we'll do, we'll add 1296 plus 3240 and 1,62,000. We will get 1,66,536. So the product of 324 and 514 is 1,66,536. Okay, we saw another example, 568 multiplied by 209. So 568 is the multiplicand and 209 here is the multiplier. So first we multiply 568 with 9, so when we do that we get 5112. Then we multiply with the tens place, which is 0 here. So 568 into 0, any number multiplied by 0 will be 0 only, so it will be 0. Then we'll multiply 568 with 200, we will get 1,13,600. Okay, then what we do, we add 5112 and 1,13,600, we get 1,18,712. So the product of 568 and 209 is 1,18,712. Then we saw estimation of product. So just how do you do that? So if you remember, we did estimation of sum and difference, okay, of the given numbers by rounding them off to nearest tens, hundreds or thousands. So we use similar method to do estimation of product. So here they've given an example. Estimate the product of 486 with 32 by rounding off to the nearest tens. Also find the actual product. So first what we do, we'll take 486 and round it off to the nearest tens. So how do we do that? 486, now rounding off to nearest tens, we look at the ones digit. Ones digit here is 6. 6 is greater than 5. So, what we do? We add 1 to the tens place, which is 8. So, that becomes 8 plus 1, 9. And 6 is replaced by a 0. So, 486 is rounded up to 490. And then 32. Now, 32 rounding it up to tens. In ones place, we have 2. 2 is less than 5. So 3 remains as it is and this 2 is replaced by 0. So we round off 486 to 490 and 32 to 30. Now to find the estimated product, we multiply 490 with 30. Now here first we'll multiply 49 with 3, we get 147. And then we have these two zeros, we'll follow up 147 with two zeros. So we get 14,700. Alright, then to find the actual product is nothing but your normal multiplication. So we'll multiply 486 with 32. So first we multiply 486 with 2, we'll get 972. Then we'll multiply 486 with 30. So when we do that, we get 14,580. So when we add these two, we'll get 15,550. So estimated product is 14,700, actual product is 15,552. Okay, so this is how we do estimation of product. Then we saw various problems in exercise 3.3, correct? So we solved these problems from exercise 3.3. Then in today's class, what we'll do is we'll start with division. So what is division? We know that division is equal grouping or repeated subtraction. Division is nothing but grouping of things equally, or it is also known as repeated subtraction. Just how multiplication is repeated addition, division is repeated subtraction. So you'll have seen how to do short division and long division methods by a one digit number, and also you have studied the DDQR rule that helps us to verify our division. Okay, let us revise these and study further. So let us recall the terms used in division first. So you know that 47 divided by 5 is 9. 9 5 is 45, so 9. And we when we do 47 minus 45, 2 will be left over. So it is 9 with 2 left over. So here the terms that are used to represent are 47 is the dividend. Okay, dividend is 47. 47 is called the dividend. Then 5 is called the divisor. Okay, and here quotient is 9. 9 is called the quotient and 2 is the remainder. Okay, so these are the different terms used. Then we also, as we saw the DDQR rule, that is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So this is used to verify your answers. So here dividend is 47, divisor is 5, 9 is a quotient and remainder is 2. So first we'll multiply 5 into 9, that is 45, plus 2 is 47. So 47 is equal to 47. So both are equal. So this satisfies the rule, which means your answer is right. Okay, so this was what you'll have learned. Now let's solve a few examples. Okay, so we have 539 divided by 8. Okay, now consider the digit 5 of the dividend, which is in the highest place. Now here in dividend is 539 and 8 is the divisor. Okay, in dividend the highest place digit is 5. Okay, but 5 is smaller than 8. So we take 53 together. Okay, we take 53 tens to together. Now we know that 8 6 is 48. It is the nearest number to 53 in 8 tables. So we take 8 6 is 48. Okay, so we write 6 directly above 3 here, and then we do 53 minus 48. So when we do that, we get 5. Okay, we do. Now we get 5. Now here what we will do is, so you got 5 now. Now again, 5 is smaller than 8, so we can't divide. So what we'll do, we'll take this 9 down. Okay, we'll bring this 9 down. Okay, so we have 59 now. So now we know that the number nearest to 59 in 8 table is 56. So 8 7s are 56. So 59 minus 56 is 3. Now here, what is the remainder? So we, our quotient is 67. Our remainder is 3. Okay, so 539 divided by 8 is equal to 67, remainder is 3. So to verify this, now we have dividend, which is 539, divisor, which is 8, quotient, which is 67, and remainder, which is 3. So if you put this in the DDQR rule, so divisor into quotient plus remainder, that is 8 divisor 8, quotient 67 plus remainder 3. So first we multiply 8 into 67, we get 536, plus 3 when we do, we get 539. Okay, so 539, which is equal to our dividend. So dividend and this answer is same. So that means your answer is verified. Okay, so this was one example. Now let's solve another example. Here we have a 4-digit dividend. Okay, 7486 divided by 3. Now here 7 is greater than 3, so we can divide it. So we'll do now 7, 3 2s are 6. Okay, so we'll write 2 above 7 and we'll do 7 minus 6. We get 1. Now here 1 is smaller than 3, so we'll take down the next number, which is 4. Okay, so we have 4. Now 14. Now nearest to 14 in 3 tables is 12. So 3 4s are 12. So we'll write 4 exactly above 4 here. And then 14 minus 12, we have 2. Okay, so we have 2. Now what we'll do, 2 is again smaller than 3. So we'll bring down 8. So this becomes 28. Correct. Now 28. Now nearest to 28 in 3 tables is 3 9s are 27. So we'll write 9 here above 8. And we'll do 28 minus 27. How much we get? We get 1. Okay. 28 minus 27 is 1. Then we'll bring down the next number, which is 6. Now 3 5s are 15. So 16 minus 15 is 1. So here your quotient is 2495 with remainder 1. Okay, 7486 divided by 3 is 2495, remainder 1. Alright, and then another question. 3892 divided by 9. 3892 divided by 9. Now see here, as the divisor here is 9, it will be easy to if we write down the multiplication table of 9 in the working margin. So here they have written the 9 table. Okay, so first they have divided. Now you can't divide 3 by 9 because 3 is smaller than 9. So they have taken 38 together and divided. So 38. Now the number closest to 38 in 9 table here is 36. Correct, so 9 4s are 36. So we'll write 4 here. And we'll do 38 minus 36. So 38 minus 36, you'll be left with 2. Okay, you'll be left with 2. Now what we do, we'll bring down the 7. Okay, so now 27, 9 3 is 27. So 27 minus 27. So we'll write 3 above 7 here. And we do 27 minus 27, which is 0. Okay, and here we have one more digit left in the number. So we'll bring down 2. Now 2 is smaller than 9 and we can't bring down any other number. So what we'll do, 9 zeros are is 0. Okay, 9 zeros are 0. So we'll do 2 minus 0, 2. So here the quotient is 430 and the remainder is 2. Okay, 3872 divided by 9 is 430 with remainder 2. Alright. So yeah. So these were examples of division, and this is short division method which we have done. So when the divisor is a single digit number, the division can also be done by the short division method. This is how the above examples will look when worked out by the short method. So here what we have done 8, 6 are 48, so we have written 6 here and we have carried over the 5. So 53 minus 48 is 5, so we have written 5. And 8 7 is 56. So 59 minus 6 is 3. Okay. So this is how you do the short division. So this is how you do the short division methods. Alright. So we have 7 4 8 6 divided by 3. So 3 2s are 6. Carry over 1 to 4. So 3 4s are 12. 2 will remain 14 minus 2. So we write down 2. Then 3 9s are 27. 1 will remain. And 3 5s are 15. 16 minus 15 is 1. So remainder 1. Okay. So this is how you do short division method. So now in your textbook, page number 124. Okay. Page 124 in your textbooks. Exercise 3.4. So here we have a few questions. So let's solve these few questions. So first question is 728 divided by 5. Okay, so let's divide 728 by 5 first. So 728 divided by 5. So what we'll do, we'll write it like this first. Then 5, now 7 is greater than 5. So, and we know that 5 ones are 5. So we'll write 1 above 7 and we'll do 7 minus 5. So how much is 7 minus 5? 7 minus 5 is 2. So we'll write down 2 here. Now 2 cannot be divided by 5 because it is smaller than 5. So we'll bring down the next number, which is 2 here. So it becomes 22. Now the number closest to 22 in 5 table is 20. So 5 4s is 20. Okay, so we'll do 22 minus 20 and write 4 here above. So 22 minus 20 is 2. Okay, now again we cannot do 2 divided by 5. So we'll bring down the next number, which is 8. Okay, and again closest to 28 in 5 table is 20. 5. That is 5 5s are 25. So we'll write 5 here above it and we'll do minus 25. So 28 minus 25 is how much? It is 3. Okay, so the quotient is 145 and the remainder is 3. Alright, so this was the first question. 728 divided by 5, quotient is 145 with the remainder of 3. Now, question B, 123 divided by 6. So, how do you do this now? So, we know 6 2s is 12, correct? 6 2s are 12. So, 12 minus 12 is 0. So, we write 2 above 2 here. And this 12 minus 12, 0. Now, we cannot divide 0 by 6, which will bring down 3. So, now again 3 is smaller than 6. So, what we'll do now, 6, and we can't bring down any other number. 3 is the last place. So, we'll do 6 zeros are 0. Okay, so 3 minus 0 is 3. Okay, so 20 is the quotient here and remainder is 3. So, 123 divided by 6, quotient is 20 with a remainder of 3. Okay, now we have 6000, question number C. 6142 divided by 4. 6142 divided by 4. So here now 6 is more greater than 4. So we'll do 4 ones are 4. So here 6 minus 4 is how much? 6 minus 4 is 2. So we'll write down 2 here. And here above 6 we'll write 1. Okay, now we can't do 2 divided by 4. So we bring down 1. So this becomes 21. So if you look at 4 table, closest to 21 we have 4 5s are 20. So we'll write 5 here above 1 and then here we'll write 20. Okay, so 21 minus 20 is how much? It is 1. Okay, so we'll write 1 here. Now again we can't divide 1 by 4, so we'll bring down 4. So this becomes 14. And we know that 4 3s are is 12. So we'll write 3 above 4 here and here we'll do 14 minus 12. So how much is 14 minus 12? It is 2. So now what we'll do? We'll bring down the last digit, that is 2. So this becomes 22. And closest to 22 is 4 5s are 20. So we write 5 above 2. And here we'll do 22 minus 20, which is 2. So here what we got, 6142 divided by 4. We got the quotient as 1535 and the remainder is correct. So this was question number C. Now moving on to the next question, question D. So question D here is 8347 divided by 7. Okay, so now the highest place, that the digit in highest place is 8. So 8 is smaller than 8 is greater than 7, so we'll do 7 ones are 7. So I'll write 1 above 8 here and I'll do 8 minus 7. So 8 minus 7 is how much? It is 1. Okay, now I can't divide 1 by 7, so I'll bring down the next number, which is 3. So this becomes 13. Now 7 2s are 14, so we can't do 7 2s are 14. So what we'll do? We'll do 7 ones are 7 again and we'll do 13 minus 7. We'll write this 1 above 3 here. So 13 minus 7, when I do, I get 6. Okay, 13 minus 7 is 6. 13 minus 7 is 6, so we'll write down 6 here. Then 6 divided by 7 I can't do because 6 is smaller than 7. So I'll take down the next number, which is 4. So this becomes 64. We know that 7 9s are is 63, correct? 7 9s are is 63. So here we'll write 9 above 4 and we'll do 64 minus 63, which is 1. Okay, 64 minus 63 is 1. And then we'll bring down the next digit, which is 7. So 7 2s are 14. Okay, 17 minus 14 is 3. So here 8347 divided by 7 gives a quotient of 1192 and a remainder 3. Okay, so this was questions A, B, C, D. So we did question A, B, C, D just now. So for your homework, you have to do question E, F, G, and H. So do these four questions for your homework. Alright, so complete your homework. In the next class, we will do division by a two-digit divisor. Alright, we will do division by two-digit divisor in the next class. Alright, thank you, students. I'll see you all in the next class.